Shakti. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Eleven. Twelve. Put in. Fifteen. Sixteen. 16. Seventeen. Eight. Nineteen. Twenty. Did you? Did you? 26. Thirty-two. Thirty-four. Thirty-five. Short self-healing sessions will help to get more energy. The energy is coming directly from cosmos. It's the union with the cosmos, union with Shiva. and the energy comes from Shiva. Deep Samadhi is happening. And because of this Samadhi only, I can continue further. Thirty-seven. I can feel the Kundalini awakening happening within me. It's a good idea to engage the Mula-banda and the Udyana-banda. It's a good idea to engage bandhas that will preserve our spiritual energy. And because of that energy, we can do further asanas, Surya Namaskars. What do you do? Forty-four. 26. It took some time to come to the Nirvikalpa Samadhi. So now, next. What's your name? Almost halfway through. It's 50. Let the all cells rejuvenate. Let the energy from cosmos enter into this body. From that Brahmanda to this Pindanda, let the energy flow. You can look into my eyes when I'm in Nirvikalpa Samadhi. You will also come to Nirvikalpa Samadhi. See how long can I hold the breath. Some granthi vedana process is happening in between when this deep inhalation and exhalation is happening, and the moment we stop our breath in between, some granthi vedana processes happen in between. Okay, let's continue. Fifty-four. Fifty-six. Did. Fifty-nine. 60. I'm gonna observe my body once more. When you observe your being, the energy will come automatically from cosmos and it will fill your being. Just see what is going inside your head. When you are really, really tired, physically tired, physically exhausted, in any exercise, not just in Surya Namaskar, just see what's going inside your head. There will be no thoughts. That state is called Nirvikalpa Samadhi, and right now I am in that state. I am speaking from Sahaja Samadhi. You may think, you are speaking and how come you don't have thoughts? But the fact of the matter is, it's coming from Sahaja Samadhi. Though, whenever the word need to be uttered, only that's when the word comes out. Otherwise, for the rest of the time, it's all Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Observe the changes within your body. Observe what's in your mind. Observe what's within your brain, not mind, within your brain. There will be no thoughts. It's an absolute unclosed space. I was in 60, right? I don't even remember. Okay, next. 62. Sixty-four. Sixty-six. Sixty-seven. Sixty-eight. Sixty-nine. 70, finally. Not easy to do all these asana, all 12 asanas. Authentically, and still keep it going. You need to be in thoughtless space. The more you are in thoughtless space, the more you get rejuvenated, the more energy comes from the cosmos, and the more efficiently you can do the yoga asanas. let's continue further. So that was 70, right? Now, next is 71. Seventy-two. Alright. 75. This is actually my first milestone. That's awesome. It will take some time to unblast myself and gather some more energy from the cosmos. It's demanding to clean up my nadis, so I'll do a little bit of nadi sodhana. I said I'll do Nadi Sodhana, but I did Tri-Netra-Kumbhaka or whatever. But I'll try to do what I'll feel that I need to do while I inhale, and then whether I will want to exhale or I'll want to inhale further, that I'll know only after I inhale the air properly to balance the energy within my system. I do that, so no, that's Nadi Sodhana, also called Nadi Suddhi. There are 70,000 nadis in our body, and the main three of them are Ida, Pingala and Shushumna. So if we keep balance of those three, the Kundalini awakening happens automatically through the seven chakras of our body. So we try to work on only these three. We can also work on Kuru Nadi, that's over here, and that comes all the way down to here, this portion of the body right here. We can work on Kuru Nadi also, but that's the talk for later. Right now we'll focus only on three nadis, Ida, Pingala and Shushumna. All right, let's continue further. Seventy-seven. Seventy-eight. Seventy-nine. Seventy-eight. 80. Eighty-two. Eighty-four. Eighty-five. Eighty-six. It is 7. Eighty-nine. Ninety. We're almost there. What I just did is called Antar-Kumbhak. What you do is you inhale slowly and hold your breath. Meanwhile, you do Mula-banda. Mula-banda means contracting the perineal region, and do the Udyana-banda. Udyana-banda means you will try to pull your stomach in and up. That's Udyana-banda, in and up. And Jalandhara-banda means you lock your chin in the chest, so that when you do when you do this three bandhas, what happens is you will lock the energies, you won't let it go outside your body. And the reason why people become weak, why people get old, is they are losing energy from Muladhara Chakra. They are losing energy because of greed, because of lust, because of desire to have tasty food, because of desire to have luxury, because of all those petty desires, small desires. Those small desires that won't take you to greater heights. Such kind of desires will only cause aging. So when you preserve that energy, the energy goes upwards. That process is called urdhareti. So to do urdhareti, you need to do this bandhas. It's called bandhas. So there are three bandhas. It's also called Tri-Banda. Mula-banda, Udyana-banda, and Jalandhara-banda. Just look at me, how am I doing it? Doing this, you will have yoga, actual yoga. Yoga means union. Doing this, you will have yoga with Lord Shiva. Shiva will enter within you. It's not that you are going to connect with Shiva. No, Shiva will enter within you. Lord Shiva has to enter within you. And actually, there is Shiva already within you, but it has to express itself, so the Shiva from the cosmos will also enter within you, so that the Shiva within you is empowered. This is how you have union with the cosmos, how you have union with Shiva, with Shakti, with Devi Parasakti. The union with Shiva will instantly take us to bliss. The feelings you see in my face, it's a emotion, it's a love with Shiva, with Guru, my Guru, Paramahamsa Nityananda, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva. He is my Guru, my beloved Guru. What am I today is because of him only. And all of this, I want to put it on his feet. All this 108 Surya Namaskar, I want to put it on his lotus feet. My beloved Guru. Okay. So next is 91, right? Okay, let's do it. Six. And seven. Hundred. Eight more to go. Do. Hmm. Number three, number four. Number five. Number six. Number seven. Hundred eight asanas. That was awesome. I feel so good about it. Let me take some time to come to Nirvikalpa Samadhi. And I'll say a few words in Sahaja Samadhi. See, yoga has to be done authentically as possible. As mentioned in our Hindu scriptures, these days yoga has become like exercise. Yoga is way beyond exercise. Yoga is not exercise actually. Exercise is just 1% of yoga. So what's happening within our system is a lot more. You can't modify yoga and make it something else. So I'll talk about it sometime later. For now, let me enjoy the bliss. And I'll keep this video unedited, absolutely unedited. I won't even remove the first part and the last part where I turn off the camera. Thank you so much. Namaste. Thanks for watching. I hope this becomes inspiration for you as well. When I started, I never thought I'll be able to complete 108. Surya Namaskar. This is my first time actually, and I'm filming it because I have confidence in my meditation. I know I can rejuvenate myself in between. That's why I started this 108 asanas in first place. Thank you. Namaste. Nityanandam.